John Wooden is about as perfect a sports personality as anyone I've met in my 40 years of broadcasting. The man was a sports Abraham Lincoln. He was a Winston Churchill. He was a scholar. He was a teacher. Plus, he was a good person.
Wooden's style, it was laid back. It was honest. It was direct.
He can say so much with so few words. For instance, he used to say this, be quick, but don't hurry.
It's about what is correct, not who is correct.
Failing to prepare is preparing to fail.
Do not mistake activity for achievement.
Happiness begins when selfishness ends.
He might have been more like a Methodist minister than a basketball coach.
Born in the farm country of Hall, Indiana in 1910, John Wooden, despite some hard times in his family, grew into a shining example of what is best in Middle America. A three-time All-American, he led Purdue to the 1932 national title. After 11 years as a high school coach and English teacher, and two more as head coach at Indiana State, Wooden landed at UCLA in 1948. 16 years later, the Bruins won their first national championship.
Somebody asked me, you know, how come it took you so long to win a national championship? And I said, I'm a slow learner, but you notice when I learn something, I have it down pretty good.
Wooden learned so well that he became known as the Wizard of Westwood, whose acquired magic rendered the Bruins all but invincible.
The best coaching record in the history of basketball, 10 national championships in 12 years, 88 game winning streak, and maybe the best of all that no one talks about, 38 in a row in the tournament.
He never scouted other teams. He didn't believe in it. He was more concerned about what his team was going to do, that if they went out and played their game, they didn't have to worry about anything that the other team was going to do because they were so prepared to play against it.
The first day of practice, he literally showed you, gentlemen, this is how we put our socks on. You know, we make sure there's no wrinkles. Because if there's wrinkles, you get blisters and it affects your play.
He knew to the precise second where we were supposed to be on the court and what he wanted to do instructionally.
Wooden was so basic in everything he did, and you could break down film and you knew exactly what they were going to do, but you just couldn't stop him.
John Wooden's on another cloud. I mean, everybody else is looking up, and he's like some rain god. He's just raining down on them. But he's the best coach our country's ever produced.
Having won more than 80% of his games, John Wooden stands atop the pyramid of America's best basketball coaches, not only for his victories on the hardwood, but for all the hearts and minds he won in the process.
For him, it was not necessarily wins and losses, but how he affected young men's lives.
Mr. Wooden had this triangle, this pyramid of all the qualities, character, fortitude, honesty, truth. And if you lived up to the pyramid, then you won games.
Winning and losing was not talked about during the year. There may be a halftime speech that revolved around the vocabulary word enthusiasm or industriousness. He would attack the situation by dealing with some aspect of the pyramid of success.
All the human values, all the personal characteristics that he preached to us that we would need in our life to be eventually successful, that's what the pyramid is all about.
John Wooden is a very religious man, and in some ways he treated the game religiously. It wasn't just winning, that you really wanted to win the right way. You wanted your players to look the right way, and you wanted them to behave the right way.
I think he's going to be remembered as the curator of the traditional values, the man who took all those one-room schoolhouse values out of Indiana, took them to a place, UCLA, this campus that was in ferment during the 60s, and somehow not just safeguarded them through that time, but was able to win championships